Okay, we're in the closed guard. We're going to look at opening the closed guard from the knees. But our initial concern is being able to maintain posture, okay? So once I'm inside the closed guard, I'm going to do a few things that are going to try to enable me to maintain posture and prevent him from breaking my posture, okay? So my knees are going to be pinched in, lifting his hips off the mat. The reason I want to do this is I don't want him to be able to drop his hips and pull me forward. Okay, so I've constantly got to use my hands to maintain posture. I want to be kind of hands free, yeah? So my knees are pinching, and then I'm going to push my hips forward. Okay, so now it should be more difficult for him to just pull me in with the legs, and I should be able to almost allow him to do a sit-up. Okay, so once I'm confident there, if he creates a grip and I feel like I'm going to get pulled down, so he starts to be able to break my posture, I'm going to really drive my hips forward and lift up, okay? So I'm gonna drive forward and lift, keep the grip, okay? To here. Now I'm going to break this grip, and as soon as I've done that, I'm just gonna step up back down into that position. So hips push forward, knees pinched. Okay, I'm never gonna stay up there because in that situation, if he's on the mat, I'm gonna be unbalanced, all right? So we're able to maintain posture, we're grip fighting, okay? The grips I'm gonna look for are just the lapel, okay, so I'm going to control his lapels and place my elbow on his hip, and then my other hand is going to go onto the side of his body. I'm going to try and get my other elbow on his hip, okay, so I want to be pushing his hips down into the ground. My knee's going to switch to the center, okay, and I still want that downward pressure with my elbows. I'm going to step my leg back and start to curl my back out, okay, so his guard's open now, and then I'm going to be able to switch my base and go to combat base. Okay, so we've opened the guard, we're in a nice safe position. Okay, so we've opened the guard, we're in our combat base position. Okay, we're going to start to work for our single underpass. I need to get one of his legs onto my shoulders, so I'm going to push one of his knees down and start to underhook the other leg. Okay, so his legs are attached, obviously. As I push this leg down, his other leg should rise up and start to go to my shoulder. I'm going to make a good grip on the trousers here. I don't want my arm to get pulled inside of the triangle. Okay, so I've got a good grip on the trousers. I'm pushing this leg down. My other hand's going to come through, and I'm going to go thumb in on the collar, okay, near the neck. Now I'm going to start to drive forward and switch my leg. So my right knee's going to come down, and my left knee's going to come up. As I bring his knee towards his face, I'm going to relinquish this grip and start to go underneath and grab his belt or his trousers and start to stack him, okay? And really drive my weight over his head to make him as uncomfortable as possible, okay? So now I'm just going to go to the side and I use my chest, okay, to clear the leg, and I can settle down into side control, okay? There's also a choke here so that I can control his trousers. Push that away and draw my elbow to the... Okay, so I'm going to attempt my single underpass, but he's going to block my hip. So there are options to deal with the hand on the hip. But what we're going to look at now is just an alternative pass that opens up when we can't go in this direction. Okay, so as my hand goes inside and I start to try to circle in this direction, he's just going to block my hip, okay, so I can no longer go in that direction. So I'm going to come back, push his leg down, my knee's going to come through, and I put my knee on the floor, okay? As I do that, I'm going to switch my hand, so I'm going to let go of the lapel, and I'm going to start to cross face, drive my shoulder in. My knee's going to go into the hip, and I'm going to back step, so I've got base here, okay? I'm not going to bring this leg out until I've cleared this leg, okay? I don't want him to close half guard on me. So now I can take that leg out, my hand's going to block the hip, and I'm going to switch and move into side control. So again, we're trying to attempt a single under stack pass, okay, and he's gonna block our hips. This is just an alternative to the back step pass. This is the over under pass. It's a little bit heavier, and you'll have more control from this position. Okay, so again, I'm starting to reach for his lapel, and I'm trying to stack from this position. He's blocking me, so I'm going to push the leg to the ground again, okay? But this time I'm going to kind of tripod up and walk around. As I drop my shoulder in, I'm going to be pushing his leg through my legs, okay? So I've got all my weight on my left shoulder right now, okay? I'm going to walk towards his leg until I can clear my leg, step over, and then walk back, cross face, and move my arm in between the legs, block the hip. Okay? So I'm in that same position where I'm trying to stack and I'm driving in and he's blocking me on this side, okay? So I can't continue to my right, so I'm gonna come back to my left. So again, I'm gonna push the leg down, I'm gonna control that hip, and I'm going to tripod up. Turn and I drop my left shoulder in. Okay, I'm going to continue to control the bottom leg. Okay, so my grip's going to stay on that bottom leg and I'm stuffing it through. Okay, I'm going to walk towards his legs, clear my own leg, come on the outside, block the hip, my cross face, and set for inside control.